And so the great Dr. Specialist drew a research appointment and kept his job on the Liberty Committee.
Gee, and I thought they were all so high class.
Sister, you should be ashamed. An amateur like you in the company of all these professionals. They could teach you something. For instance, you'll probably go to jail. But do you think they will? Not on your committee button, they won't.
Will Mr. never get here? It seems we've been here hours.
I insist that man be stopped. He's already caused enough trouble. What is this, Russia? We don't have to listen to talk like that.
No. No, you don't have to listen. You're all independent, you are. There ain't no Mr. There's just the boogeyman. You preach what he tells you to preach. You print what he tells you to print, or else you sell out everything you've got. Your store, your son, yourself.
Steve.
Mr. comes around, and you kiss the ground where he walks. Mrs. Mr. lifts a finger, and you lift your little behind to be smacked. This ain't Russia, no. It's Steel Town, USA!
What do you want us to do? Join unions?
A university president's union?
A concert artist's union?
Don't make us laugh!
I got some sort of invitation to join a pharmacist union. I wonder if they know there's a pool room now where my drugstore was.
Didn't anybody ever tell you boys you belong to a union already? It's the closest shop ever heard of, and it's been running things for quite a while. Only you've been rooked. You're in one of them racketeer unions where you run all the errands and get maybe a dollar cigar for Christmas. You ain't made one real demand yet. You've only said,
oh, yes, Mr.
up till now. You're caught there, boys! You're stuck like a sandwich between the top crowd pressing down and the bottom crowd coming up! What do you want to be? Hamburgers, I ask you?
You're Larry Foreman.
Ex-foreman.
I've been looking all over town for you.
Well, how's the union returns?
They haven't come to a decision yet. Mr. Foreman, I know a lot about you.
You were once in my employ. Look here. Both for the same thing, a fair and square deal for everyone. Why don't you persuade your group to join with my Liberty Committee into one big united organization?
You mean with these people here?
Oh, yes, a bad mistake their being here. Release them at once. I told the judge to go on home. I have his authority. That includes you too, Mr. Foreman, of course.
You got his authority, eh?
Yes, my brother-in-law, you know.
Oh, the judge is your brother-in-law. He's part of the Liberty Committee, too.
And some of the best people in town. Dr. Specialist over there. Editor Daly, you know him. And they're all very democratic. Come now, what do you say?
Let me understand. You'd like my services in swinging your way all the people I've signed up for. All the people that agree with the union. You want me to change their minds. Is that it?
That's it. Well, that's a little strongly put.
Oh, come now, Mr. You can be perfectly frank with me.
When all this trouble's over, I'll see to it personally that there's a wave of increased production, improved methods, and closer competition than this country's ever seen. do they know that I'm building them a swimming pool, a library, and a private park for their children?
From where I sit, it looks like they only want a union.
And I don't want to talk about your own future. There's nothing you couldn't be. I don't have time to argue. Well,
I might, but it's a pretty tall order, you know.
Well, I don't expect you to do it just like that. I thought so.
A murderer!
You needn't worry about that part. I'll see you get what it's worth.
Watch your step, boy.
Do you understand?
Let's talk it over outside.
I'm kind of funny that way. I'd like to know now about how much it might be worth.
Go on, you son of a bitch! You lousy foreman! Who do you think you are?
Stop it!
Go on! I know why! I can't!
Breaks.